Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here in our online service. And last week, we have started streaming it on Facebook already. And the reports that I got is very encouraging because dumami yung tao kagad on the first week. So before anything else, share mo muna to on Facebook or probably also in your Make a Wine at Online that church. You can also share it there. Share it to your friends, and so that many more will be reached by the Word of God, encouraged by the Word of God. We are on the second week of our series. It's called The Ability to Produce Wealth, and the theme, overall theme of the series is Do Not Forget. Do not forget. Merong dalawang mag-asawa, nag-uusap sila, nagkwentuhan. Pareha silang makakalimutin. Okay, at nag-aasaran sila. Sabi nung asawang lalaki dun sa asawang babae, Mami, or Honey, pakikuha naman ako ng ice cream. O sige, sure. Up, bago ka umalis. Ano nga ulit? Ice cream. O sige, up. Ano nga ulit? Ice cream. Bakit mo pinaulit-ulit? Eh kasi makakalimutin ka. Kilala na kita, makakalimutin ka. So, ulitin mo lang para lang sure ako. Oo nga, ice cream. Ice cream. Ayan. So, umalis yung babae. Pagbalik, may dala hotdog. Sabi nung lalaki, sabi ko na sa'yo, makakalimutin ka eh. Ayaw mong maniwala. Sabi ko sa'yo, makakalimutin ka, ayaw mong maniwala. Kita mo na, nakalimutan mo yung ketchup. Ayan, parehas lang pala silang makakalimutin. And, like if you missed the last week's preaching, go ahead. It's on our. Marami na tayo ngayon. We have Spotify for you who wants to listen while driving, okay, or maybe while biking. That's what I do. You can also watch Spotify. Also, go to Victory Makawayan YouTube page or my personal page to watch the recap. And there are memories that are good that guides us, instructs us, inspires us. And just like this, the next set of pictures I will show you, merong craze that happened in the Philippines a couple of weeks back. It's called the BTS meal. Ayan. Yung unang-unang stand niyan ay yung nagka-camera sa akin ngayon. crazy because these people, pag tinignan niyo to, pinatuyo nila yung mga, it's just an ordinary cardboard, by the way. It's ordinary paper na may nakalagay lang kulay purple, BTS meal. But because they want to remember it, they want to make it special, yung iba, tingnan nyo, pinatuyo pa nila yung kanilang mga pinagamitan and made shrines. BTS meal shrines. Ayan, so, ayan, dumami na bigla yung follower. Dumadami yung nanonood dahil sinabi ko lang yung BTS. Ganun talaga yun. Ayan, tingnan mo ito, gumawa siya. Ito naman, nilaminate niya. Ayan, nilagay niya sa isang picture frame together with the receipt. Just to be a memento, right? A remembrance. Ito yung favorite ko. Ginawa niyang keychain yung mga sauce. Yung sweet chili and Cajun sauce. Kasi, in a few years, when all the craze is gone, you will not remember it. You will forget it. Pero at least, pag nakita mo yan, nakasabit sa kama mo, mali, sa bedroom mo, nakita mo yan, tapos nakita mo na dun sa picture frame, it sparks. And it's a wonderful feeling. That is the same way kaya tayo bumibili kahit na mga ref magnets lang. Right? In a place that we've gone. For example, you went to Boracay. And simple-simple lang naman, ang liit-liit, right? And then you will buy it, put it in your ref, because that little thing will spark memories. Remembering the things that happened that you maaring makalimutan mo na without all of these things. The thing I love about Israel, the nation, is that they have many feasts, that is, the purpose of that feast is to make them remember their past. And for example, this is the Feast of Tabernacles, or Feast of Booths, or Feast of Sukkot. And na-feature to nung Chosen, I think season 2, episode 4, I think. Okay, gumagawa sila ng mga tents, gumagawa sila ng mga booths. And remember, the people who are not aware, like Matthew, they asked, ba't ba tayo gumagawa nito? But bakit tayo dito titira? So the idea of the Feast of the Booths or the Feast of Tabernacles is that meron naman sila mga bahay, and yet magagawa sila ng mga mini tents outside, booths as they call it, and then they will live there for a week. 1 week sila doon. Again, ano, may bahay sila, and yet doon sila kakain, doon sila titira sa mga booths. And the idea for that is to remember. So that they will remember that for 40 years that they don't have any house, that they don't have any belongings, any possessions, and they lived in tents like this. That's the point. That's the idea. And then yet God provided for them. Very beautiful. Very beautiful imagery of remembering who you were and where you were until God saved you. That's the whole point of the whole Deuteronomy chapter 8. Again, recap lang of last week. Moses is already 120 years old and then he's giving out these reminders. Kasi maiiwan na siya, kukunin na siya ni Lord, and he doesn't want the people to forget because they will now enter into a land of prosperity, a land of milk and honey, a land of overflowing bread and pomegranates and all of this, and they might forget where they came from. So basahin natin ngayon. We will be studying Deuteronomy chapter 6 for today. Sabi dito verses 1 and 2, "Now this is the commandment, the statutes, and the rules that the Lord your God commanded me to teach you, that you may do them in the land to which you are going over to possess, that you may fear the Lord your God, you and your son and your son's sons, by keeping all his statutes and his commandments, which I command you, all the days of your life, and that your days may be long." Verse 3, "Hear therefore, O Israel, and be careful to do them, that it may go well with you, and that you may multiply greatly as the Lord, the God of your fathers, has promised you in a land of flowing with milk and honey." I want to highlight this one. Sabi dito, "Hear therefore, Israel, be careful to do them." Anong what them? The commandments, the laws, the statutes. Remember I talked about the statutes. Statutes are, it came from the word statues. Ito yung mga bagay na hindi magigiba. Ito yung mga bagay na puso ng Diyos. Ito yung mga bagay na will niya at purpose niya and things. And you will go to that land, be careful to obey them. So kung isa-summarize ko to, what we have learned last week and what we have read so far, dalawang bagay lang. Do not forget and obey. Do not forget and obey. Alam nyo, obedience, pagka naririnig natin yung obedience, medyo we think of it as a legalistic. We think of it as just like rules. And of course, yes, it's rules, pero obedience is actually, it's like a treasure map. Diba? May pangako si Lord sa kanila. The land that they're about to possess is already there. In fact, that's already, it's them, it's theirs already. Sa kanila na yon. Ngayon, just like a treasure map, you have to carefully obey the treasure map. Pag sinabing 1 kilometer and then turn right, kasi sa treasure map, wala ka namang makikita. Right? Wala namang markings. Pag sinabing 30 steps and then 60 degrees, you really have to carefully obey it or else you will not get what is already yours. You understand? So, obedience is like the treasure map. And whenever obedience is being said in the Bible, being talked about in the Bible, I feel it is the same way. It's not really do this or else. No. Because of the covenant, God already blessed you. God blessed us. Because of Abraham, God already blessed us. Now, in order for us to fully enjoy His blessings to us, we have to carefully obey. Three things, no? Three applications and three commands, actually, three commandments from the whole Deuteronomy chapter 6. Paano ba natin hindi makakalimutan ng isang bagay? Diba, kasi na-confuse siguro kayo last week na, dapat di natin makalimutan ng Diyos. Pero paano talaga natin actually gagawin? Paano natin hindi makakalimutan ng Diyos? Three things and three commands that we can see from the verse that we're gonna read. Number one, you love. You love. You love it. When you love something, you will be so passionate about it. And in fact, automatic sa'yo na gawin yung bagay na yun. Kasi nga, mahal mo. Ito yung cake ni Yuel nung birthday niya. He celebrated 6 years old. Last July 1, 6 years old. And pag tinignan mo yung cake niya, States of America yan. Crazy story about this. Meron siyang favorite book. Ito, The Scrambled States of America by Lori Keller. Crazy story kasi Carmen and Yuel tried to chat Lori Keller. Inanap lang nila si Lori Keller sa Facebook. Tapos, ang galing kasi sumagot si Lori Keller. Ngayon, si Lori Keller, this famous author, and Carmen are now chatmates. And she's the one who drew this picture, sent it to us to be Yuel's cake. Amazing! Di ba? Amazing! And ngayon, di na makalimutan ni Yuel. And he loves the states of America. He can recite all 50 states of America. Again, something that you love, you will not forget. Kasi mahal mo eh, passionate mo, second nature mo. Just like I can recite the 30 teams of the NBA and all the players of the Phoenix Suns, right? Something that you love, you won't forget. So one application, one tip, and one command, love it. Number two, you lecture it. Lecture it or teach it. Ituro mo. Diba, laging sinasabi sa amin, paano mo ma-maximize yung learning mo sa isang bagay, halimbawa isang libro, pag binasa mo siya, that's already great. But if you really want to grasp the whole idea of that book, you teach it. Kaya pag may mga book akong gusto, ginagawa akong book study sa Victory Group namin. Kasi mas natututunan ko pa siya. At lalo ko pa siyang hindi makakalimutan. You love it, you lecture it, and live it. Number three, you live it out. It's not just a theory, but you are breathing it. It's part of you. It's part of your system already. So, itong tatlong bagay na to, again, commandments of God from Deuteronomy chapter 6. Let's apply it. So, number one, you love. Okay? Who? Love Him. Love Him. Verse 4, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. This verse is very, very important to the Jewish faith, to Judaism. This is what you call the Shema. Okay, naalala ko na naman yung The Chosen Jade, puro Shema, Shumuel, Shimai, parang Shomai, puro ganyan yung mga pangalan mo. The Shema, Shema means hear, okay? Shema, Yisrael, Adonai, Eloheinu, Adonai, Echad. Kailangan may dahak yung Echad. Echad, yan, ganyan ang Hebrew. And this is very central to the Jewish faith. In fact, they recite this every morning and every evening. So every morning, Shema, Yisrael, Adonai, Eloheinu, Adonai, Echud. Tapos, you shall love the Lord your God. Because it's counterculture to the culture that they have nung time na yon. Nung time na yon, almost everyone are polytheist except the Jews. Polytheist means poly, many. Theist, God. So maraming Diyos. And you already know that. We already have that in our culture. Yung mga Zeus, sila Athena, all of these gods. And the Jewish people are saying, no, it's just one. There's just one God. And we are teaching it. And this God is someone na, pansinin nyo, the Lord, okay? He has a name. Okay, so some translations, actually, ginagamit lang nila yung Adonai kasi they really don't want to speak the personal name of God. Kumbaga, as less as possible mong sabihin yung the personal name of God because that's so holy to them. So yung the Lord, Yahweh, di ba, the tetragrammaton, YHWH, may pangalan siya. So ngayon, ginagawa nilang Adonai, not that it's any less, but Adonai means master or Lord. Pero pag nakita nyo sa Bible nyo, tingnan nyo ngayon, big letters, L-O-R-D. So you can change it to Shema Yisrael Yahweh. And that means it's a God. It's a personal God. A God that has a name, a God that has feelings, a God that can be sad, can be happy, can be angry, a God that you can relate to. Okay? And it's very important to them. At the same time, just like what I've said, He is a God that is holy. Kaya nga, even just saying the name is so, let's not use it haphazardly. Kanina sabi dun sa verse 2, that you may fear the Lord your God. You and your son's son, by keeping all His statutes and His commandments, which I command to you all the days of your life, and that your days may be long. I think what's missing in this culture, this generation, is a healthy fear of God. To be honest. In fact, I'm telling you this right now, that there's only one God, and probably some of you are getting bored. Na parang, yeah, can you go to number 2? Kasi alam na namin yan. Alam na namin na isa lang ang Diyos. Yes, our generation, but that idea is already being challenged right now by other worldviews. Why? People don't have the healthy fear of the Lord. That we think it's okay to just not attend church. We think it's okay to not keep His commands. Not keep the Sabbath holy, not tithe, not commit adultery, not steal. Laging, dati parang takot na takot tayo magsinungaling. Dati takot na takot tayo na kunin. At least yung kahit ba bond paper lang ng eskwelahan. Pero ngayon, the truth is being twisted. So I'm teaching you this so that we can teach our sons. I'll get to that later. The healthy fear of God. To keep His commands. Okay? Because He is a holy God. He is a holy God. And, verse 5, you shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, with all of your mind. The Shema is very important because this is the greatest commandment. Jesus quoted it in Matthew 22, if I'm not mistaken. What is the greatest commandment? He said it's the Shema. Right? You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your might, mind. And He added, and also you should love the neighbors as you love yourself. If you see the word shall, it's a command. And again, sa generation natin, in the cancel culture generation, ito na naman tayo. I can already hear the Gen Z's talking or tickety-tacking their keyboard, mga keyboard warriors. I can already hear them na, of what? Are you forcing us to what? Parang, I'm offended. Ganun kagad. No? I'm offended. Are you forcing us to love you? Of course, you cannot force us to love you. Love should be a feeling, love should be automatic, a response. Love should be, dapat kusa yan, hindi dapat yan inuutos, at hindi yan nire-request. And that thought, that mindset actually is why there are so many failed marriages in America. Kasi they're talking about love as a noun. Right? That love is a emotional bench. Ano nga, what is love? Pakidefine nga. Love is a emotional feeling, right? It's the butterflies in your stomach. It's this kilig. It's this magic. It's this thing that you feel, that passionately feel about someone or something, and that you cannot stop it. The question is, what if that feeling is gone? And that's the problem, my friends. Right? In America, or probably even here, hey, Pastor, wala na kasi. She's not the guy that I'm married. She's not... I was attracted because she's pretty and she's sexy, but right now, it's not like that. So it's not my fault that I fell out of love. That the magic is gone. And again, all of the Hollywood movies and the songs... specifically the Taylor Swift songs. By the way, I'm a Swiftie. Okay, I love her songs. So it's making us think that love is a noun. And I guess, of course, it is. But if you think of it as a verb, then things will change. That love is something that you do, whether you feel it or not. And I think that is why in the Shema, it's a command. Because the truth is, I don't know about you, there are mornings that, may mga morning talaga na, lalo na yung nagpunta kang Baguio or Tagaytay, grabe naman talaga, di ba? Pag gising mo, grabe Lord, salamat po, grabe. Ginising ka ng tweet, 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 di ba? Parang si Snow White, ginising ka ng mga ibon. So, sino pa naman ang hindi? Paano kung nasa ilalim ka ng MRT? Brr, 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 yun yung gumising sa'yo. There will be mornings that you don't feel like loving God. There will be mornings that you don't want to go to church or to open your Bibles. But the question is, are you gonna stop? Are you gonna stop because you don't feel it? No. The reason why it's a command, because, and it's the same thing with marriage, by the way, kaya in-institute ni God yung marriage is that you will love your wife regardless of what you feel. And as you do that, the emotion will start going back. Kaya ito yung lagi ko sinasabi, emotion precedes emotion. There are many, many days that I don't, sobrang nakakatamad mag-victory group. Sobra talaga. And then mag-chat ako and then some will not respond. Guys, di ko kayo pinapatamaan. Mga taga-victory group ko yan. And yet, every single time, right? Every single time after the victory group, after you've heard them, after they shared, after you prayed for one another, di ba ang sarap? The emotion is there already. Parang, the same thing, di ba? May mga time na parang, mag-church ba tayo? Hindi. Tamad, wag na lang. Next week na lang. Total, pangat naman series. Pero is there really a time? Can I really honestly ask you, was there a time that you attended the church and when you went home, pangit? Meron ba talaga? Meron ba? I've been a Christian for like almost all my life. There was never a time yata na parang I was not encouraged and I was not uplifted and I was not healed and I was not encouraged because it's always worth it. Because motion, mauuna yung motion, gawin mo muna before the emotion follow. Was there really a time when you read your Bible? Sa umaga ang hirap, right? Magbasa ng Bible. Pero pag ginawa mo na, di ba you feel, buti na lang ginawa ko. So, the number one commandment in Deuteronomy chapter 6, the most important thing, and I hope that we will have more time to study the Shema because, again, it's central to our faith, is to love God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. Might. Number two, you teach it or you lecture it. Okay? You shall teach them diligently to your children. Alin? The commands, the statutes, the ways of the Lord. Okay? And you shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. You lecture it. Let me ask you this question before I continue. What's the greatest inheritance we can give our children? Ano yung pinakamagandang pamana na maibibigay mo sa anak mo? Is it money? Is it education? Is it good job? And I can almost see the typical Filipino families. Right? And I'm sure lahat kami dito nasabihan na ng ganito na, anak, mag-aaral ka ng mabuti kasi yan lang ang ama, ipapasa namin na res sa inyo. Yan lamang ang maibibigay namin sa inyo. Wala tayong pera, pero yan lamang, mag-aaral ka ng mabuti. Kasi para magkaroon ka ng magandang trabaho at para gumanda buhay mo. Of course, all of those things are good, but is that it? Is that just it? What will happen if that's the only thing? That's the and I think in our culture we're putting too much emphasis on academic excellence, to be honest. That our kids should be on top of our class, on top of their class, and should have all of these medals, and should have all of these accolades and all of these dean's lists. So that they will have a great job, right? And they will have money. And then if they're there, okay? Let's say they're there. Good job. Good job. Na nagawa mo yun sa kanila. At they're there. The boss of their company or probably the owner of the company. What then now? Ano naman? Is the world a better place? Or isa lang yung anak mo sa mga api ng mga ibang taong maliliit? Or isa lang yung mga anak natin sa mga prideful na, eh, hindi ka kasi nag-aaral ng mabuti. Ako, pinag-aaral ako ng mabuti. Kaya ka ganyan ngayon kasi. If they have a business, and that's all that matters, that's all that you've taught them, the diligence, the excellence, the business skill strategy. And I'm not talking about eternity yet. Kung ang anak mo ay naging successful businessman or successful employee, and he got so many money, wealth because of it, became famous because of it, had a great life here on earth because of it. And then now what? When their time is up here on earth. And then now what? Ayaw mo bang makasama yung anak mo, mga anak mo sa eternity, sa langit? So if there's one thing, this is not just an opinion, I really believe this. The greatest inheritance that we can teach our children is the love for God. The Shema. That our children will love our God with all of their mind, their strength, their heart. You know why? Kasi pag, if that is fixed, then everything will follow. Tama ba? If your child is passionate for God, then he will be excellent with his studies. Then he will be diligent. Then he will, but at the same time, he will love people. He will not have a proud heart kasi alam niya na it's all by grace. Na ituro mo yun eh. Alam mo, anak, matalino ka, pero hindi dahil sa'yo yan, dahil sa Diyos yan. Don't push God out of the equation. So Moses is telling us to tell our kids, you shall teach them diligently to your children. You shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. In short, every time. Three applications of this. Teach them during meal times. Alam nyo, meal times are the best. So please lang, Daddy, Mommy, just drop your phone when it's meal time. And now is not the time for multitasking. And I'm saying it to myself as well. Na kumakain kayo pero may ka-meeting ka. O sige, sabay ko na to. Or you're browsing Facebook. Teach them during meal times. In fact, as early as two, as they began to speak, they have a lot of questions. And I know it's sometimes, and again, we're teaching this to ourselves, Carmen and I. Kasi sometimes nakakainip. Parang hindi pa maubos-ubos yung pagkain. Daming tanong. Daming tanong. Pero opportunity mo yun to teach of God's principles and values and His heart about things. They would ask, and Dad, why is it like this? Why is it like that? Dad, why did we do this? Why did we do that? One of the things that we love doing, ito, maybe you can try this at home. We have prayer popsicles. So, meron kaming mga popsicle sticks and then we distributed it to everyone. I had my own. Yuel has his own. Carmen has his own. Sulat namin yung mga prayer requests namin. Nandun din yung Phoenix Suns. Phoenix Suns Championship. Kita mo, sinasagot ni Lord yung panalangin natin. Si Yuel nagsulat dyan. Ang nakalagay dyan, si Job. Job is the son of Pastor Lloyd. Nakalagay dyan, Job no virus. And we're teaching them to pray. And I love Yuel's prayers. Some of it, binivideo namin from time to time. Also, there's a verse na kasama, randomly, we will pick. Ito, James 1 verse 2. Yung popsicle na nakuha naman yan, si Lola Marisa. Count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds. And then we will pray that verse to the item that we have got. And it's a wonderful practice. Okay, it's a wonderful that we, before we even pray for our food, we do this. And please, you know, ngayon pa lang, I can almost feel the negativity, hindi mag-work. Ganda sana yan, Pastor, pero hindi mag-work sa amin yan kasi ako lang Christian. Hindi mag-work sa amin yan kasi si tatay, try nyo muna. Let's try it. Lalo na, I'm talking to you, if you're the father of the household, you set this. Okay? You talk to your family na, no, this is what we're gonna do. Alright? I don't care how busy you are, but no, we're gonna do this. And make your mealtimes conversational. Talk about things. Talk about what happened yesterday at school. And maybe you can pick up some things from there. Kasi, bakit meal times? Kasi available lahat. Hindi na siya randomly lang na, anak, kausapin niya kita. Everyone's there. So teach them during meal times. Teach them during discipline times. Pagka naspunk sila, lalo na yung mga bata, we really have to be diligent, as the verse says, to talk about it. Hindi lang yung palo. No, sometimes the kid needs to be processed. We needed to know why he hit the guy. All obviously, siya yung mali. Pero we needed to know, okay, what happened? Why did you hit? And those are the times that they are vulnerable. Sa una, sobrang yabang pa nila. No, I'm not Jennifer Kim! Pero as you talk to them, as you take time, minsan matagal po talaga. Matagal talaga. Doon sila magbe-breakdown. Tapos doon na sila iiyak. I only did that because kasi. And then you teach the Word of God. Right? Again, what are we gonna teach them? The commands, statutes of God. So what is God saying about in that situation? Ano ba sabi ni Lord? Oh, okay. Sabi ni Lord, we forgive daw eh, even if he's not asking forgiveness. So I know this hurts you, my son, but you have to forgive. You teach them habits. Number three, spiritual habits. Teach them how to read their Bible in the morning. Teach them how to pray, like what I've told you, I showed you during lunchtime. Teach them to attend kids' church. Okay, right now we have kids' church online every last Saturday. So, ikaw na mismo yung magpa-excite sa kanila to make sure that they would do. Teach them that every Sunday, non-negotiables, magki-kids church sa YouTube. Teach them, no negotiable, that daddy and mommy will watch online during 10 o'clock and 12 o'clock. Don't, please, we want to concentrate. Teach them that. Teach them the spiritual habits. And again, wala, hindi po nila makukuha to. Okay, most of the time, lalo na nung youth pastor pa ako dito sa Victory May Kawayan, I've talked to a lot of parents. Kakausapin ako, tapos ganito yung words. Ganito yung sobrang nakakatawa. Pastor, projectin mo nga yung anak ko. School project, projectin mo nga. Kailangan na maging kay God. Kasi and ganito po siya. Puro kaka-computer po, ganyan. And of course, respectfully, no? Of course, I would say, yes po, we're going to try our best. Pero, guys, we're just here once a week. Even pre-pandemic, no, the kids church teachers, the Ian campus, we just see them once, twice a week, but they're with you every day. So partner po tayo, tatay, nanay, daddy, mommy, partner po tayo. Hindi po pwedeng projectin nyo nga po ito. Hindi pwede, hindi namin kayang projectin na. Hindi po kaya eh. Dapat po sa bahay pa lang. Nai-instill na yung mga habits. As Moses said. And it should not be, alam niyo, a program. Alam niyo, all right, 11 o'clock, we will talk about Jesus. Hindi siya ganun eh. Kaya nga sabi kanina, when you sit, aba kailangan, ilang beses ka ba umuupo in a day? When you sit, when you walk, when you lie down, when you rise. So it's just a figure of speech saying every single time. Like what I'm always telling you, and I'll talk about this on the next point, no? Wala sanang hati yung pagiging Kristiyano natin tsaka pagiging ibang tao. Proverbs 22 says, train up a child in the way that he should go. So when he grows up, he will not depart from it. Amazingly, nung binalikan ko ulit ng verse na to, the Hebrew for train is hanok. Spelling H-A-N, dahak, O-C-H, ganun. Hanok is to stimulate. And the idea is that yung bata, kung ayaw nila mag-feed, nakaganon, nakatikom yung lips, si-stimulate nila. Lalagyan nila ng honey. By the way, yung the land of milk and honey, it's not honey from bees. It's not. When we went to Israel, naghanap kami ng bee. Wala! It's dates pala. Honey from dates. Okay, so lalagyan nila ng honey from the dates. Yung dates, yung parang prunes, parang raisins na malaki. Lalagyan nila ng honey from the dates yung lips ng bata. And then it will stimulate. Gaganon kasi siya eh. Hanggang sa gusto niya ng matuto. Makakain. Ganon din. Yung sinasabi ng Bible. Stimulate mo yung anak mo. In the ways of God. Stimulate them to hunger and thirst for God. Right? Sa una, hindi talaga, they would not like it. But if that's the only thing that you talk about God, you talk about Jesus, you talk about Moses, and you talk about all these people in the Bible. Obviously, at some point, kakagat yun, kakamot yun, masistimulate mo sila. So, Again, how can we not forget God and obey His commandments? Love God above all. All right, number two, we teach it. We lecture it. Pag tinuturo mo, ikaw din, naalala mo kasi ikaw nagtuturo. And lastly, to live it. Live it. Amazingly, because in the Shema, hearing is the same Hebrew for doing. So nung sinabi kanina ng Shema Yisrael, hear O Israel, hindi yun pakinggan mo lang. Shema means hearing and doing. And this is the problem, I think, right? We treat Sunday, we treat Victory Mega Wine Online just like Netflix. Napapanoorin mo, tapos hindi mo naman gagawin. Kasi sanay tayo sa ganun. Baka nanood ka ng Sherlock Holmes. Di ba na-amaze ka? Uy, galing naman mag-solve ng case nito. Ni Sherlock Holmes. Eh, pero immediately, hindi mo naman gagawin. Hanap ka ba ng sino bang pinatay dyan? Apply ko nga to. Hindi mo naman gagawin. Right? If you saw how Avengers traveled through time, wow! Amazing! It's not like you're gonna do it. O kaya yung mga nagko-Korean novela dyan, it's not like you're gonna speak Korean the whole day. You're gonna apply it immediately. Nasanay tayo doon. Now, everything that we watch or read is just for entertainment, but we're not actually applying it to our own. This is not the case, my friends. What you have taught or lectured, you should live it out. Apply it. And this is only the book. I can honestly say this. Confidently say this. That this is the only book that you can apply all the principles and you will not go wrong. Hindi ka mamamali. Hindi siya ma-outdate. And there's a very, the imagery here is so powerful. Look at this. So, sabi, di ba? Verse 4, love the Lord your God, obey His command, His statutes to your son, teach them, ganyan. And then ito pa, verse 6, yata to, you shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. Ay, ang galing nito kasi hindi ko alam na may ganito, buti na lang. Pinag-aralan natin to, I stumbled upon this. So, this is actually a literal, mukhang metaphor, no? You shall bind them. Alin, yung commands daw ni Lord, yung laws ni Lord, i-bind mo daw sa kamay mo, tsaka ilagay mo daw somewhere between your eyes. But in Israel, they're actually doing it, literally. It's called a phylacteries. Phylacteries or in Hebrew, tefillin. Tefillin. So ang itsura po niyan, may box, ganito kaliit, parang tesseract. Pero mas maliit. Tapos nakabind sa kamay. Isa sa kamay, isa sa ulo. Tapos, merong tatlong verses or actually, pericopes sa loob ng box. Isang Exodus chapter 13, verses 15-16, Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 4-9, and Deuteronomy chapter 11, 13-21. Mga maliit na nasa papel nandun sa loob ng box. Nakatali sa kamay at nakatali sa ulo. Bakit sa kamay? Kasi malapit sa puso. Bakit nasa ulo at nasa mata? Kasi malapit sa mind. Tsaka malapit sa mata. It's a beautiful imagery that everything that you've known, everything that you have been taught in the preaching, in all your quiet time, as you do your hand, pag lumabas ka na, okay, pag sumakay ka na sa MRT. Kasi kung meron ka talaga niyan, literally, and like what I've said, sila, ginagawa nila yan, I think once a week. Eh, hindi, makakapangbugbog ka ba? Eh, may nakatali yung kamay mo dito, may word of the Lord sa kamay mo, para makakapangbugbog ka ba? Mabubugbog mo ba yung asawa mo? Eh, hindi, siguro hindi. Kasi meron, the word of God is on, literally on your arms. Makakapangupit ka ba ng wallet? Tapos yung mata mo, eh yung box literally is in front of your two eyes. Can you really look at porn? Can you really look at a woman that's not your wife? Eh, nandun. Ay, makukonsensya ka talaga. In fact, gagawin namin to lahat ng staff starting Monday, guys. We will have phylacteries for us to protect our amazing imagery, right? But it's a picture of as you live your daily life, I hope it's not just Sunday. I hope that the Word of God is in your mind, just like that box is in your mind. As you think, as you decide, as you become generous, as you are being violently in, there's injustice in your house, as you go to the grocery, as you drive, the Word of God is literally on your mind and on your heart and on your arm and in between your eyes. Na lahat gagawin mo sana in the lens of the laws, the commands, the statutes of God. When I was young, I still have it, by the way, at our house. Meron ako yung WWJD. What would Jesus do? And it's something like that. And whenever I see that, what would Jesus do in that situation? Ano bang gagawin niya? Kapag kakinat ka, Jade, tas nagbabike, parang, Pastor, hindi ka po ganun. Oo nga, sorry na. Pag kinat ka, ano ba, awahin mo ba? Kailangan natin maglagay ng phylactery sa mga helmet natin. Because it's an image that we live it out. We have to live it. It's not, again, it's a statute. It's never, ever, ever, ever gonna change. Kahit 1,000 years pa, it's not gonna change. All His commands. And when the Lord God brings you into the land that He swore to your fathers, we're nearing the end here, to Abraham, to Isaac, to Jacob, to give you with great and good cities that you did not build, and houses full of all good things that you did not fill, and cisterns that you did not dig, and vineyards and olive trees that you did not plant. And when you eat and are full, then take care lest you forget the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. It is the Lord your God. You shall fear Him, you shall serve, and by His name you shall swear. Again, bago pa tayo pumasok doon sa land na yon. Kasi, napaka-susceptible talaga yung land na yon sa pride. Why? Eh, wala ka nang pinaghirapan doon eh. Tingnan nyo, cities that you did not build, houses that you did not fill, cisterns that you did not dig, vineyards that you did not plant. Kumbaga, reward na to. Reward season na to. Nilireward lang ka ni Lord na hindi mo naman deserve. Hindi naman ikaw naghukay nun eh. Tsaka hindi naman ikaw ang nagtrabaho doon. Makakalimutan mo yung Diyos. So, bago pa tayo pumunta doon, gawin mo na to. Live, lecture, live it out. Love, lecture, live it out. Gawin mo na to. Kasi para pagdating mo doon, meron ka ng in place. Just like the phylacteries, the Word of God is in your arms and in your mind, in your head, that you will not forget the Lord. I'll end with this. Verse 20. When your son asks you in time to come, what is the meaning of the testimonies and the statutes and the rules that the Lord our God has commanded you? What's the meaning? Okay, one day daw, your sons will ask, bakit ba tayo? May bahay naman tayo, tatay. Bakit ba tayo nandito sa booth? For 1 week, lamok-lamok dito. Lamig-lamig. Bakit ba tayo pumapatay ng 10 na lamb? Tatay, sayang eh. 100 yung lamb natin, yung 10, pinapatay mo. Bakit mo ginagawa yun? Ba't mo tinatithe? Bakit ba tayo, tatay, ang dami-daming trabaho, Abba in their culture, Abba, why are we not doing anything on Sabbath? There's so much work that needs to be done. We need to say, parang sila Peter, no? Kailangan marami tayong ma-fish. Pero ba't kailangan natin mag-stop? Sabi doon, your son will ask you. And this will be your reply. You shall say to your son, verse 21, we were Pharaoh's slaves in Egypt. And the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand. And the Lord showed signs and wonders, great and grievous against Egypt and against Pharaoh and all his household before our eyes. And he brought us out from here that he might bring us in and give us the land that he swore to give our fathers. In the same way, our children will ask, okay, Daddy, why are we giving our tithe? Why do I see you writing that check every time? Why do I see you inuhulog mo yung envelope there? I mean, mukhang di naman kailangan ng church yung pera. Bakit tayo nagbibigay ng pera? Bakit ako magki-kids church? Kailangan ko maglaro. Bakit natin kailangan mag-onsite? Ba't natin kailangan kumanta? Why are we doing this? Bakit daddy, every Tuesday, wala ka, may victory group. Tapos every Wednesday, si mami naman, si mami Carmen naman. You have to tell them na anak, the reason why we're doing this to God is because we were slaves as well. Now we don't have a future. But your daddy is a very, very bad person before God saved him. Your daddy, Ruby, is a very, very bad, worthless piece of trash before God saved him. And giving my tithes, worshiping him every Sunday, keeping the commands that he taught me is just one way to say my thanks to God. And I'm doing this. I'm teaching this to you, my son. Kasi it benefited me. And right now, because of the grace of God, things are going okay. Because I have kept the statutes, the commandments, and the laws of God. I wasn't very good, my son. In fact, I'm probably the worst. And yet God, in His mighty hand, saved me. That's why I'm doing this. Look at that. I'm going to highlight that. Verse 23. And He brought us out from there that He might bring us in and give us the land that He swore to give our fathers. I love that. Let that stay with you for a moment. He brought us out so that He can bring us in. Wow. I love that hindi lang sila pinalaya sa slavery. Tapos-tapos na. Sige, lumaya na kayo. Bahala na kayo sa mga buhay niyo. O bahala na kayo sa wilderness. Ha? At least I did my job. Pinalaya ko na kayo. No. It did not just brought us out from our past life, our sins, our worthless life. He bring us in. He brought us into His family. Alala ko tuloy, maraming meme ngayon eh. Kay Tom, no one's stronger than family. So, but it's the truth. God's family. Right? He brought us out of our past life, out of our selfishness, out of our sinful life. Inalis niya tayo doon para maipasok niya tayo dito in a land full of purpose, prosperity, in a land where He is King, in a land where all will be well. Right? God's definition of being well in sa ating mga pamilya, sa ating mga buhay, sa ating mga family. So love, lecture, live out the commandments of God. Thank you, Lord, for this day. We ask your Holy Spirit, Lord, to do this kasi on our own, we cannot. We will fail and we will be reversing back to what we continue doing, or what we used to do, rather. And we are sorry for that. Thank you, Lord, for these commands. Okay, to love you, Lord. To love the Lord your God with all your heart, with your mind, your might, God. Thank you, Lord. And as it is central to their faith, I pray that it will be central to our faith as well. That walang pinakamahalaga but to loving you above all else. And to teach this same thing to our sons and our sons' sons, God. And Lord, that's the greatest inheritance that we can give them. Salamat, Lord. That, just like the picture of the phylacteries, Lord, that's on our arms and on our eyes. Lord, I pray that everything that we will do, we will do with the lens of your word, your commandments, your statutes, Lord. Na pag ginawa ba namin ito, mag-glorify ka ba namin? Or are we doing something that would neglect your laws? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God, that you have taken us out of that slavery and into this place of prosperity. Maraming salamat, God. In Jesus' name. Amen. See you next week. We will continue this series, The Ability to Produce Wealth, and I hope you invite more friends.